and this is Prague from B&WTek. Thank you for joining us for the first installment of our educational video series. Today we're going to be talking about emission spectroscopy. So Prague, can you start us off by explaining emission and why it's important?
Sure. One of the basic definition of emission spectroscopy could be when particles, either atoms or molecules, go from a state of high energy to a state of lower energy by emitting a photon of light. Some of the basic applications could be you could measure the emission spectrum of that LED light source over there, or the different colors on your iPad. More analytical applications of emission spectroscopy would be something like a flame test, where you could identify the different elements within a unknown compound or mixture.
Okay, great. Can you show me how to take a measurement like that?
Sure. What we have today is the exemplar spectrometer from B&WTek. And it has a fiber patch cord attached to it with a collimating lens at the front.
Okay, and what is the purpose of the collimating lens?
Basically, all the collimating lens does is it restricts your field of view, so light coming from other light sources doesn't interfere with your measurement, and you're measuring the same spot no matter how far away from the actual light source you are.
Okay, now what if you wanted to take in all light rather than just a concentrated area?
Okay, so what you would basically do is remove the collimating lens and attach another accessory that we have, which is the cosine corrector. And that would collect light from 180-degree viewing angle. Also, if sometimes people want to collect light from 360 degrees, and you would basically attach this fiber patch cord to a integrating sphere. So what I'm going to do first is just take a basic dark spectrum.
What is the purpose of a dark spectrum? You said a dark scan.
Oh, okay. So every spectrometer has a detector in it, and the detector is made up of a number of pixels which collect the photons. even in the dark state, we have some amount of residual dark current or dark charge that we call, and this might interfere with your actual reading. So what we do is we collect a dark spectrum and then save it and subtract it from the actual reading.
Okay.
So, now, I've already collected the dark spectrum as we were talking, and if I take a single acquisition right now of this LED light source, we can see the different characteristic wavelengths of that light source. If you could also put this up against the different colors on the iPad, we could see the different characteristic wavelengths of the green, so you see there.
Okay.
Red would be another cool one to see. And all I'm doing is taking a single acquisition here, so just acquiring one spectrum.
Okay.
You see red. If you put it up against a yellow, you could actually also see that real quick.
Now, that one looks like almost a combination of the two we just saw.
Well, yeah. When you take that iPad, for example, there are three basic pixels, red, green, and blue. So yellow becomes a combination of red and green. So you see two different characteristic wavelengths for the red and green there.
Great. Can you talk a little bit more about applications that we would use emission spectroscopy for?
Well, more recently, we've been seeing a lot of activity for applications like laser-induced breakdown spectroscopy, or other applications in the semiconductor industry could be plasma endpoint detection. LED binning and sorting could be one of the applications as well. So these are just a few to point out.
Okay, great. Well, thank you so much for your time today. I hope that you found this as educational as I did. If you'd like more information, you can call an application specialist by dialing 1-855-MY-BWTek, or you can visit www.bwtek.com and visit our learning lab and also check out future videos. So thank you.
Thanks.